What's up guys, Peter here from Reviews on Anything, and in this video we're looking at some shoes from Adidas. This is the Adipure 360.3 shoe, which is sort of your all-round training shoe. It doesn't really have a very specific purpose, but it's very lightweight and according to Adidas has quite a few exciting things worked into this that should sort of benefit the shoe despite the fact that it doesn't look very exciting. So we're going to take a closer look and see what's what. Okay, so here we are with the Adipure 360.3 shoes. Now this is a shoe, according to Adidas, aimed at women, but these are in my size, as you can probably tell by the comparison to my hand, and for me they work just fine as well. There's actually quite a lot to these shoes, despite the fact that they look kind of dull, and I'd say that is actually, you know, on the one hand, a benefit because I kind of like understated shoes. I'm not really interested in how my shoes look, you know, when I do any kind of sports I want them to be functional. But on the other hand, you could also say that this is quite the boring shoe in general, especially when you compare it to other products from companies like Nike, for example. These shoes we looked at in another video, obviously much more color and much more interesting to look at. But we're going to take a closer look at these shoes and see what is what. Let's put one to the side and let's go. All black and white, this one, as you can see, it's a pretty traditional shoe design, except for the back here, which we'll get to in a minute. The bottom of the shoe is non-marking, which is obviously a nice benefit. It means you can use them indoors. And as you can probably tell by the structure of the sole, it is not really aimed at a very specific sport. It's sort of an all-round shoe that you can use maybe in a gym environment, and you can do a bit of running in it, some sprinting, some jumping, maybe even CrossFit. It's sort of an all-round shoe you can use in quite a lot of environments. And thanks to the non-marking, you can also use it indoors, which is always a good thing, of course. Now, let's have a look. Here on the front, we got some mesh going on, which is obviously good for ventilation in general and breathability of your feet. And the mesh is actually goes all the way through here to the back. As you can see, I can put my hands underneath the shoe itself, and the way the laces are constructed, that's actually an extra part that sits on the outside of the actual shoe construction. It actually continues here towards the back, towards the ankle. I compare it a little bit to if you've ever worn sort of surf shoes or wetsuit shoes. That's a little bit how it feels to get into these. Just your feet sort of plop in, and then it closes around your foot thanks to the flexibility of the material here. And it might sound a bit funny, but it's actually quite comfortable. Once you have them on, you're like, ooh, I can work with this. And actually, thanks to the mesh design and the sort of, I suppose it's, I wouldn't say it's rubber, but the wetsuit-like material, it's a very light shoe. So it's a shoe that's, you know, easy to wear for a longer period of time because it's so light. Now Adidas says that this mesh construction is a, and I quote here, it's a four-way stretch mesh that adapts to all movement without pressure points for a maximum natural feel and maximum breathability. That is of course lots of marketing blah blah, but in essence it is true. The breathability I already mentioned really works, and since sort of the whole upper part of the shoe is you know, disconnected from where the laces are, it's sort of one piece. And that actually does mean that there's hardly any pressure on your foot anywhere. Of course, when you put your laces super tight, there will be pressure. But in general, because it sort of forms around your foot once you have it on, it's actually true. The pressure is minimal to none. And thanks to the lightweight shoe, it's actually quite a comfortable shoe to wear for longer periods of time, like I said. Now, obviously, there's all kinds of exciting structures going on here inside the shoe to make sure that you have a good footbed, a stable platform, and that your foot doesn't sort of wobble about in the shoe, because despite you know, the fact that it's one piece, obviously if the laces weren't there and if the inside of the shoe wasn't designed properly, your foot would still just flop about everywhere. But the upper material sort of hugging your foot together with the lacing system, which might seem odd at first, but once you have your shoes on, you're like, actually, makes sense. That combined with a good footbed and a good insole make for a comfortable shoe in general. I find wearing these, you know, for half a day at a time, training clients both indoors and outdoors, it's quite a, you know, a nice shoe to wear. Without, you know, being too geared towards any kind of sports. It's a shoe that, you know, it sits comfortably. You can even walk on it quite comfortably if you just if you're into you know, just walking your dog, for example. You can wear these shoes and all will be well. I'm not too much a fan of the white here, because that's obviously something that will get very dirty very quickly. But that's, you know, personal taste. If I kind of like the two-tone design though, which is I suppose a nice touch. Adidas logo here on the back, Adidas logo here on the front are the only two markings really on the shoe. So it doesn't stand out too much, which is something I like, but like I said in the beginning of the video, it's, you know, it's quite a boring shoe to look at in general. Now these are non-expensive shoes, which is both a good and a bad sign. Obviously if you just want a shoe that is, you know, a decent all-rounder, you can pick this up without having to worry about it, and from a brand like Adidas, you know, you're gonna be sure to have a good pair of shoes. On the other hand, because it's an all-rounder, because it's not a high-end shoe, you can't expect that much from it. It'll get you along just fine, but if you're a serious athlete or a serious performer in any kind of sport, then obviously you want to look at a more specialized shoe, either from Adidas or from, you know, competing brands. I find they're quite nice. Surprising, actually, I was a bit underwhelmed when I took them out of the box, but that feeling went away quite quickly when I put them on. It's a nice shoe, it's comfortable, it's light, it's breathable. And altogether, it's a good shoe, you know, if you just want something to get you by for the occasional sports activity, this is something you can pick up without having to worry about it. This was Peter from Reviews on Anything with a look at the Adidas Adipure 360.3 shoes. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!